Here in the United States, we are now on the cusp of summer. That magical time of year when you're reminded how ugly everyone's feet are. And while there's a lot to love about summer, thanks to climate change, there's also gonna be more than ever to hate.
Historic heat, record-smashing temperatures across the West. 101 in Denver, 107 in Salt Lake City. Death Valley approaching the hottest temperature ever recorded on Earth.
The oppressive, stifling heat wave searing the West is tonight delivering some of the most dangerous temperatures of the year, threatening to shatter nearly 200 records through the weekend. Some 40 million Americans already under heat advisories, watches, or warnings.
Some experts are warning of pavement burns. A burn center in Phoenix says sidewalks and roads could heat up to around 180 degrees there.
Nevada and Arizona were warning people, do not walk barefoot anywhere. Don't walk your pets in the heat of the day. And take a towel with you for grabbing and opening door handles.
The National Weather Service also gave out this warning to people out west, saying, quote, no easy way to say this, so we'll just cut straight to the chase. It's going to be very hot for a long time.
That's right. Very hot for a long time. Also known in meteorology circles as the Halle Berry phenomenon. And guys, if we don't do something about climate change, very hot for a long time is gonna be the weather forecast for the rest of the century. It'll be the first thing we tell every baby born from here on out.
Welcome to the world, baby. It's gonna be hot for a very long time.
I mean, it is dangerously hot out there right now, people. In some places, the sidewalk is 180 degrees Fahrenheit. You've got to be insanely careful at that temperature. I mean, look at what happened to this guy who just went outside to check his mail. So like people, I just hope that everyone stays safe and everyone listens to the experts on this one, because heat is no joke. And I know Americans, a lot of Americans don't like being told how to protect themselves. First it's masks, now they're making us wear shoes. Scientists can't tell me what to do. I'm going outside. Ha, 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 take that, Fauci, ha, ha. Now, of course, climate change isn't the only threat to humans on the planet. There's also asteroids, God's WMDs. But now, NASA is a step closer to at least knowing when they're coming.
NASA approved the launch of an asteroid-hunting space telescope to help prevent potentially dangerous collisions. The new aircraft would use infrared technology to detect most of the potentially hazardous asteroids and comets that come within 30 million miles of Earth's orbit. According to NASA, there are already more than 25,000 near-Earth objects, but scientists believe there's many more waiting to be discovered. The NEO surveyor is scheduled to launch sometime in 2026.
Shh, dude. What are you doing? Don't tell them it won't launch until 2026. Now the asteroids know they got 5 years to light us up. What are you doing? I mean, look, I'm glad that they got this telescope going, but the bad news is that all it can do is see the asteroids coming to us on Earth. We don't have any way to stop them, right? We're helpless. So Earth is basically just going to be me when my mom was coming at me with the belt. What we should be focusing on is not asteroid detecting technology. We need asteroid destroying technology. Because people, we cannot, and I mean this, we cannot let an asteroid wipe us out. The dinosaurs are gonna roast the shit out of us in heaven.
Well, well, well. Look who's also a bunch of fossils now. Oh, did the asteroid not care that you had opposable thumbs?
And to be honest with you, if we can't do anything to stop the asteroids, I would rather not be warned that far in advance. Like, I want to know maybe 5 hours before the asteroid hits. You know, it gives me time to get home, be with my loved ones, spend my last moments hugging them, you know?
Oh, I'll see you on the other side, guys. I love you so much.
But if we find out we're gonna die in a month, I mean, that's just too far away. I can't hug my family for that long.
I love you. I love you guys so much.
You guys wanna go watch Loki or something? I heard it like wraps up a lot of the endgame story. And still, This telescope is an amazing technological achievement. Although, as we're starting to see, the major flaw of every piece of advanced technology is that at some point, it will probably get hacked. And that includes everyone's favorite stationary bike that went to college, the Peloton.
Peloton users may be vulnerable to hackers accessing their information. The company is warning of a new security threat relating to the touchscreen on their Bike Plus. Wouldn't it be creepy? You're working out, suddenly somebody could see you? Cybersecurity company McAfee discovered the flaw. The company says hackers could access the user's screen and could potentially spy on riders using the microphone and camera feature. The threat most likely affects bikes used in public spaces that have public Wi-Fi, such as hotels or gyms. Still very creepy.
Yeah, that's definitely creepy. I don't want some Russian hacker taking over my Peloton spin class.
Give me 10 Bitcoin or I will push you harder than you've ever been pushed.
But I don't have 10 Bitcoin.
Okay then, we're doing the mountain level. Faster, faster! Believe in yourself, Trevor!
You gotta admit though, that's gotta be the absolute bottom rung of the hacker hierarchy, right? Because you've got hackers who are shutting down the oil industry, and then you've got other hackers who have all of Facebook's user data, and then you've got one guy who's like,
I watched Karen Silverman bike a 5K. Yeah, big time.
Like, my question is, why would you want to hack into someone's Peloton camera? We're in the golden age of television, and you'd rather watch someone's bike face for half an hour?